following particulars, prepare profit and loss account of Hanuman Bank Limited for the year ended 31st March 2024. I am reading second problem. Essay type second problem I am reading now.
Okay.
May I?
Yes.
From the following particulars, prepare profit loss statement of Hanuman Bank Limited for the year ended 31st March 2004. Zero zero zeros are already omitted. So, my dear student, he is asking you to prepare profit loss account. First page you have to leave. Why? Answer is, on the first page you have to prepare profit and loss statement. You have to prepare profit and loss statement. From second page onwards, you have to start preparing what's the schedule. The first you prepare schedule. Once the schedules are completed, then you have to prepare what profit and loss account. How to prepare profit and loss account? In the same fashion as I explained in my previous class. Income. In the income, first one interest earned, schedule 13.
Yes, sir.
Other income, schedule 14.
Interest
13 plus 14, that means interest earned plus other income, you will get total income.
Yeah.
Then expenditure will start. Among the expenditure schedule, what's the 15? Interest expended. Schedule 16, operating expenses. Provisions and contingencies, no schedule number. Adding 3 items, you will get total expenditure.
Yeah.
Total income minus total expenses. The resulting figure is termed as profit for the current year. Current year profit. Then last year profit, if it is given to you, you can take, otherwise you are not supposed to take. Then appropriation. Every bank need to transfer 25% of its current year profit to a reserve called statutory reserve. Am I correct? Every bank need to transfer 25% of its current year profit to a reserve called statutory reserve. Transfer to statutory reserve. Then whatever the balance is left over, the balance is to be carried over to balance sheet. So how to prepare profit and loss account is based on my previous class, you need to know. Three problems we worked out on that day. Yes or no?
Yes.
One problem I have solved and two problems you people have solved on that day after my explanation. Today also, first you do one thing. First page you leave. Second page onwards, you have to prepare schedule numbers. What schedule you have to prepare? Schedule 13, interest earned. Schedule 14, other income. Schedule 15, interest expended. Schedule 16, operating expenses. Then PNC. PNC, if items are there, then you are supposed to prepare PNC, otherwise you leave it. Now let's start. Get ready. Read with pencil. Interest on loan granted. Schedule 13. Interest paid on RBI borrowing. Schedule 15. Because interest paid. Paid means 15, no?
Yes, sir.
Then PF contribution.
16.
16. Depreciation on building.
16.
Interest on fixed deposit.
15.
Interest on cash credit.
15.
Postage, telegrams and telephone. 16. Net profit on sale of land and buildings. 14. 14. Other income. Locker rent. 14. Because you are providing locker facility to the customers and you are charging rent from them. Bank usually does. Yes or no?
Sir.
So locker rent is the other income of the bank. Schedule 14. Salaries, including 20,000 to general manager. Salaries from take under schedule 16. 16. Operating expenses. Auditors fees.
16.
Income on investment. 13.
Interest on
commission, exchange and brokerage.
14.
Interest on overdraft. 13. Other income. Because somebody has overdrawn the amount, on that amount you are charging interest. So interest on overdraft is the income of the bank. Don't think from the angle of the customers. Think from the angle of a bank. Think that you are on that side of the, you know, counter. Yes or no? If you think interest on overdraft, correct, it is an expense. You may think that way. Don't think from your angle, from the angle of the customer. You have to think from the angle of what's the banker. So banker charges interest on overdraft. Charges means interest earned. Schedule 13. interest on overdraft
13.
Debt received, director fees and allowances
16.
Rent received
14.
Rent received
14.
Other income
14.
Discount on bill discounted
13.
Very good, excellent, superb. Interest on SB deposits
15.
SB deposits, somebody has deposited and you are giving interest on that. Interest expended. SB means saving bank deposit.
15.
People have deposited in a saving bank deposit and you are paying interest on that. Interest paid on saving bank deposit is the expense of the bank.
Schedule 15.
Net profit on sale of investment. Profit on sale of investment
14.
Listen, my dear student, income on investment. Income on investment, interest on investment 13. Profit on sale of investment, profit on sale of land, profit on sale of building, profit on sale of any asset
14. Other income.
That quite what slight difference. And there is a chance of what sir committing mistake also. Income on investment
13.
Interest on investment 13. Yes sir. Interest on government what sir loan
13.
Because you are receiving interest. Profit on sale of investment, profit on sale of asset, profit on sale of land, profit on sale of building, profit on sale of any asset
14.
Other income. Understood? So when he uses the term profit
14,
when he uses the term income
13.
Net profit on sale of investment
14.
Income from non-banking assets
14.
14, 14 sir, 14, 14. Other income.
Yes.
Transfer fees
14,
other income. Law charges 16, printing and stationery
16,
rent rates and tax, rent taxes and lighting
16.
So what you are supposed to do, leave the first page. From second page onward, schedule forming part of financial statement, there schedule 13 interest earned, schedule 14 other income, schedule 15 interest expended, schedule 16 operating expenses. Prepare all the schedules. Once the schedules are prepared, dump it into the profit and loss account and prepare what profit and loss statement. Start solving.